need a website. It doesn't really matter what for, but what does matter is that you don't want to pay a developer to make this website for you, which means the responsibility of building the site falls on your shoulders. But that's absolutely fine, because these days there's so many great website builders to choose from that are beginner friendly or will be tailored to your level of skill. There will be something there that lets you build the exact website that you want with no coding required, and it will be brilliant. Trust me. That's exactly what we're going to look at today. So stick around, like and subscribe to WP Beginner, and we'll show you some of the very best website builders to get you going. So how are we going to pick the best website builder? Well, we're going to have some criteria that we want these website builders to meet. However, you also need to just have a quick think. What is it that you want your website builder to do so that you can go through this list and kind of tick off the ones that suit your requirements? The first criteria we're going to be looking for is how easy is it to use? We want drag and drop here. Absolutely no code, but we still want it to be highly customizable. Next up, pricing. It has to be affordable and it has to offer good value for money while at the same time offering you all the tools that you need. Like, are you going to be selling something? Do you need e-commerce? And how much is that going to cost you to add to your site? Next up, design and features. You obviously want to make this look as good as possible, but you also want to make it look like you or your blog or your business. You want to be able to create what you are imagining. How many designs and templates are actually available? And are you going to be able to add other features that you want as time goes on? Maybe SEO tracking or marketing tools or forms, are they available? Also, customer support. Should that user-friendly interface we're looking for encounter a glitch? Is there some customer support to help you? And if there is it 24/7? That would be nice. And finally, data ownership and portability. This might not be the first thing that you think of, but it's definitely quite important. Do you actually own the data that's on your site? Even if you're putting it there, does somebody else then own that data? It's definitely worth having a look at the terms of service and the privacy policy before you sign up. Bundled with that, we want to make sure that we can move our data, move our website somewhere else in the future should we want to. We want to be able to do that quite easily. First up, definitely the most powerful website builder that's on our list, WordPress.org. Not WordPress.com. Have to say this every time. That is a different entity altogether. Talking .org here. WordPress.org is the most popular website builder on the internet. It powers about 43%, almost half of all the websites on the internet. So I'd say it's in pretty good hands. So let's talk about positives. For design and features, WordPress.org is pretty much unmatched. There are thousands of themes. There's over 60,000 plugins to give your website different functionality. Whatever you can dream of, you can pretty much achieve with WordPress.org. If you are looking to get a really fully custom design, then we would recommend a plugin like SeedProd. SeedProd is a page builder that really is going to let you kind of dial in exactly what you want for every single element of every single page on your website. If you do want to check out something like SeedProd, then check out the link down below in the description where you're going to be able to get it at the best price with WP Beginner. You don't have to use a paid page builder at all, and WordPress itself is actually free. There's a couple of costs to consider, but we'll get onto those in a second. And with regards to your data, you have complete ownership of the data on your site, and it's pretty easy to move around should you choose to do so in the future. We will tell you now that WordPress.org is definitely our number one pick. It's just the most powerful, the most flexible, the most customizable. It's really difficult to beat WordPress.org. But obviously, we're going to go through all of the other options. You might find one that suits you a little better. And now we'll have a look at a couple of the downsides for WordPress.org. While there is no coding required, to use WordPress effectively, you really need to be familiar or get familiar with the WordPress admin dashboard, the back end. Now, it's not super complicated to do, but something that you absolutely have to do. And as I mentioned earlier, there's also a couple of costs that we do have to consider. Now they're pretty low, but you need hosting and you're going to need to provide a domain name. So WordPress.org is a self-hosted service. So you're going to need to go to somewhere like, for example, Bluehost and get yourself hosting. Now Bluehost, you can get for as little as $2.75 a month if you head down to the description and find the discount code there, the coupon code from WP Beginner. It's a really fantastic price and it's gonna take care of all your hosting needs for your WordPress site, which you are gonna need. And on top of that, I mentioned that you need a domain name, your .com, .org, .net, etc. Well, you can get that for free if you use Bluehost as your hosting provider. They'll bundle in an SSL certificate, a free domain name, along with a whole heap of other stuff. And they'll also take care of some of the things like security and backups, just to make your life a whole heap easier. We highly recommend checking out Bluehost for your hosting, which you're going to need to run your WordPress site. If we haven't sold you on WordPress and you're looking for a hosted alternative, so you don't have to go out and get your own hosting, then we really recommend checking out web.com. Web.com is, again, very beginner friendly. It's all drag and drop and, again, no coding required, which we love. There are also thousands of templates that are really easy to apply, and there's loads of powerful website tools for things like SEO, alongside you being able to add galleries, videos, forms, a whole host of things onto your web.com page. For customer support, there is unlimited chat and phone support available. So if something should go wrong, although we found web.com to be very reliable, the support is there for you if you need it. Web.com have some really great introductory offers for pricing. You can get your first month for anywhere from $1.95 to $3.95, depending on what features you want. Now that does go up after the introductory period, but it's well worth checking out. Let's talk about the downsides. If you are a beginner, you're just looking to get started with either a blog or particularly a business page, web.com is likely to have everything you need. Now that doesn't sound like much of a downside, but as you progress and as you grow, you might find that it doesn't have all the tools available that you might want. You could end up missing out on some of the more powerful features that you're going to go looking for. If you are a business and you are focused on e-commerce, then web.com only offers you 50 products via their e-commerce platform, which might sound like a lot, and it could be when you're first getting started. But again, as you grow, is that e-commerce limit going to hold you back? And finally, in the downsides, we've mentioned that there might be some limitations as you grow with web.com. Well, if you do grow beyond the confines of web.com and you want to move onto another platform, say you do want to go to WordPress.org, you're probably going to find that incredibly difficult. It's very difficult to move from a web.com site over onto something else. So future planning is encouraged. Another great WordPress alternative, drag and drop style website builder with absolutely no coding required, is Wix.com. Really easy to get started and well worth taking a look at. For the upsides, Wix.com is fully hosted, so you don't have to organize or pay for any hosting, which is great. And it's also, as mentioned, drag and drop, so nice and simple to use. For design and features, there are loads of templates and designs to choose from. There's even an artificial design intelligence which can help build a website for you, which could really take some of the stress out. And then there's also free and paid apps, and you can add those to your page to get certain functionalities that you might be looking for. For pricing, there is a free plan with Wix, but it's only really any good for testing out, seeing if you like the website builder and how it works. We wouldn't recommend trying to use it to actually run your website on the free plan. And that's a good place to kick off the downsides. If you do upgrade and you pay a bit for your site, those lower priced plans are going to show Wix based adverts on your site. So Wix branding and Wix are going to run ads on your site, and they're going to take the money for that, not you. If you want to remove them, you're going to have to go for the more expensive combo or unlimited plan. So make sure you know how much change is in your pocket. Also worth mentioning that the entry-level Connect domain plan doesn't come with a domain name included. So you'll also have to get one of those and provide it. It's about $15 for the year, not particularly expensive, but it's another cost to consider. If you do need e-commerce, the e-commerce plans start at $23 a month, so that's baseline. And similarly to web.com, if you outgrow Wix or you want to change your mind, it's actually very difficult to move to a different platform. So you want to be sure that starting with Wix is where you want to be, because you might be stuck with Wix in the end. Now to go in a slightly different direction and talk about e-commerce with WooCommerce. WooCommerce is the most popular e-commerce website builder on the planet. So if you're looking to start an online store, this really could be for you. And if we are talking about running an online store, WooCommerce has pretty much every single feature that you could possibly want. We're talking shipping, delivery management, inventory management, pretty much anything you can think of, including allowing 88 different payment options. I don't think I know 88 payment options, but they are available with WooCommerce. And then to really start to customize your store for your customers, for what your business needs to be, there's also tons of plugins available. You can get Opt-in Monster that's going to help you try and reduce cart abandonments. You can get things like SeedProd to make custom landing pages. There's also affiliate programs using Affiliate WP. The options are kind of endless for what you want to do. For the downsides, obviously this is very focused on e-commerce. So if e-commerce isn't your thing, then this is definitely not for you. And also, similarly to WordPress.org, this is a self-hosted site. So you're going to need to provide hosting and a domain name to get yourself going. Again, you can use a company like Bluehost or SiteGround, and they have specific hosting for WooCommerce sites. And they'll take care of some of the security, backups, and maintenance that you need to consider when you do have a self-hosted site. Pricing for hosting can really vary. And for example, a SiteGround startup plan for hosting can be as little as $2.99 a month. But if you're a really high traffic site, most people tend to kind of deviate towards WP Engine, which starts around $30 a month. So it's about what your site requires. How busy are you? Next up is HubSpot. You might know HubSpot as an all-in-one marketing or content management platform. Well, within their tools, they have a fantastic website builder. It's a really great drag and drop system to help you get a customized website, but our favorite feature is that you can do an adaptive testing system. You can have up to 5 variants of the same page, and HubSpot will show them, monitor them, and make sure it's serving up the best performing version to your website visitors. As you'd expect, this all integrates with the HubSpot CRM to help you use the data most effectively, and there's some great, really powerful tools at your disposal as well. When you consider all of those tools that are available with HubSpot, it becomes a very attractive option for simple business websites. If you're looking for something a little bit more advanced, or maybe something that's e-commerce focused, then you're definitely going to be better off with WordPress.org. However, there is a plugin for HubSpot on WordPress.org, so you can kind of get the best of both worlds and combine the features of the two. The HubSpot website builder on its own, along with some of their great features like the CRM and live chat, can be obtained for free. And if you want some of the more advanced features, plans start from around $45 a month. So in conclusion, we will conclude exactly what I told you at the beginning. We think that WordPress.org is just simply better than the other options. It's more powerful, there's more options, and there is a lot more room to grow. You're not gonna outgrow WordPress.org with all the different things that you can do for either you, your blog, or your business. Now, if you do want to avoid WordPress.org for some reason, then we recommend trying out web.com. Web.com is a really powerful alternative. And if you're purely looking for e-commerce, then of course WooCommerce is really the way to go. Those are our picks. If you have any other ideas or any other questions, put them down in the comments. And while you're in that area, make sure you hit the subscribe button, as well as popping a like on the video. And if you want to find out more about what hosting provider to use for your WordPress website, then you can click on this link just here to go and watch that video. But that's all from me here today. I hope you've had a good one, and I'll see you soon.